I spent actually quite a bit of time working with senior leadership teams to try to get them to get outside of their four walls. And we do use this concept of the saturation plan to do that, where we have them take things they're specifically interested in. So it doesn't have to be a work-related topic, that's what we tell them, but they try to purposely learn more and more about that topic. And then we always come back and say, now how could you make application from what you just learned to maybe your business? You know, can you take some kind of analogy from it or make some sort of transition happen? And that's where, you know, we come in, right? You tell me everything that you learned, and then we help them try to draw some of those correlations. But obviously, it gets resisted from time to time. People kind of see it as a waste of time. No, if I'm going to do this, I need to read a book about my industry or whatever. We really encourage them to find things that they're interested in because it's easier to get them started. And I was working with one particular senior leader, and she really didn't want to do this, right? And she freely admitted. She said, hey, this just doesn't seem like something I want to do, and I'm not necessarily normally a reader anyway, but she gave it a shot, sort of reluctantly. And I got to follow up with her several times, and about 2 or 3 months later, she actually became the poster child in her company for somebody that took these saturation plans to the next level. Her interest, was in shopping. And she was like, okay, Wes, I'm going to take you at your word. That's the thing I'm interested in the most. Let's see how this works. And then so it's like, okay, well, where are you interested in shopping at? So she picked Neiman Marcus. Well, she got a couple books on the history of Neiman Marcus, and then she was hooked because she realized that, who started the company and the way these brothers did it, and then the way their children got involved in it, this one woman in particular, and how she picked the brands in the store, and then how they really started to focus on customer service and how to make sure that every one of their brands really, really supported their theme and who they were and their strategy. And she really, and just more she read, the more articles she got into, and then she was excited. She was excited to tell the stories. And so then what we're able to do is sit down and say, look, that is fantastic. You're right at this height of enthusiasm now. How do we capture that? How do you make that translate into your business? Well, she actually was a very senior manager that ran the sort of the back office, if you will, all the support functions for all the products and services sold by this company. And so her very focus was customer service. So she had dozens of examples of how, quote unquote, Neiman Marcus did it and the decisions they made. And even if they couldn't actually mirror exactly what they did, so she understood the strategy and the thought process, she was better able to go back at her organization and said, look, I don't know what the answer is going to be, but here's how we need to start thinking. And then to me, that's a home run. And when you get that passionate, that's contagious, and other people in the organization do the same thing.